It looked like somebody was bent over and had their head in the window of the deer blind. It either heard me or smelt me, and he pulled his head out of the tent and stood straight up, and that shocked me. They don't make people that big.
The way it moved, almost as if it was gliding across the beach. I've never seen anything move like that in my life. They were screaming at each other in gibberish. It sounded like a language, and they were chuntering away back and forward, back and forward, back and forward. I know what a bear looks like, and there is no way on this planet that what I saw were bears.
What are you reporting?
Jesus Christ, you better... Sheriff, Gina!
Hello?
Get somebody out here.
What's going on now, sir?
That son of a bitch is about 6'9", I don't know.
Do you see him now, sir?
Yes, I'm looking right at him.
Uh-oh.
Hi, this is Carol King from Music City, and you're listening to Sasquatch Chronicles.
Welcome to the show, everyone. Thanks for being here tonight. Got a great show planned for you. We're going to be chatting with Dan. And Dan had an encounter in Utah. He was actually out camping with his girlfriend when they had a run-in with one of these creatures. It's a pretty fascinating account, especially how Dan describes the movement. And as Dan and I were talking, he was telling me he grew up on this property, basically out in the middle of nowhere in California. And a lot of really weird things happened around that property. Now the family kind of uses it as a vacation house or vacation cabin. It's pretty remote. But Dan was telling me about different things that happened to him as a kid kind of growing up around that property. And they just thought that it was weird. They didn't really know what was going on. And but Dan will be talking a little bit about that property tonight. And we're also going to be talking to Ben. And Ben is actually a veteran. He grew up in Michigan, and him and his brother actually had a couple run-ins with a very strange creature. And it's very intriguing because Ben was telling me that growing up, his little brother was terrified of monkeys, and no one knew why he was terrified of monkeys. I think after you hear the encounter tonight, you'll kind of understand why. If you've had an encounter and you'd like to be on the show, shoot me an email. My email address is wes@sasquatchchronicles.com. Let's jump into it tonight. I want to welcome Dan to the show. Dan, thanks for coming on.
Hey, thanks, Wes. Appreciate it.
Yeah, Dan, I appreciate you being here, man. And what I'd like to do is kind of start with the most recent encounter that you and your girlfriend had in Utah. If you would you kind of tell us what you were doing and walk us into what happened?
We were up there on vacation. We were at a campsite. We were out there for 3 nights. We had a windstorm first night. I could barely sleep. Second night was fine. So the third night we're there, and each night we had done this, we have our campfire out in front of the tent. I told my girl, you know, each night we turn out all the lights so you can see the stars. So we were in our chairs each night, and we're looking up at the stars and just enjoying nature. Everything was uneventful. But what happened was we were out there on the third night. The fire's dying down. It was around, I want to say, 11 o'clock at night. Now, I gave my girl a green laser pointer. I have it in my survival pack, so, you know, in case you get lost and you can actually signal somebody with that sucker. It goes for half a mile. And so she's playing with this thing, shooting it up into the sky. So that's, I don't know if that's what attracted it or what, but I turned to her and I said, hey, do you hear somebody walking around in this field over here to the side of our tent? And there's a sliver of a moon out, about to go down, over the horizon. So there's no other light except for the stars. Our campfire is pretty much dying down. And she says, hey, put another log on. I said, we're done. You know, I mean, we only got so much firewood, and this is our last night. So it's just as good. Just let it go. And so I said, yeah, you hear something walking around? Somebody walking over there? She says, yeah, somebody's walking around over there. So kind of looked over there. I don't see anything. And I went back to it. Well, we kept hearing it. So finally, I turned around in the chair, just kind of scooted around. And I said, who's walking around over there? Or who's sneaking up behind me? That's what I said. Who's sneaking up behind me over there? I turned and looked. And then, Wes, I just glanced. I looked right over to the right. And it's standing there. And we locked eyes. I don't know how to say it. I didn't even have time to look at anything else, but just we locked eyes. And he was as surprised as I was. The facial expression or the eye, just the expression in the eyes is what it was. The pupils just changed just instantly. People talk about these eyes glowing. They did glow, but a very, very faint glow. It wasn't a refraction from any light. There's no moon. There was a sliver moon underneath some clouds, and the moon was actually red in color. And it's standing upright, and it goes down to the ground on three, not all four, but on three, with one arm, digging in. It's like a chimp running away. You see him, wherever you've seen the chimps running away from something or running at something. And they put that one hand down, and they use their knuckles, usually like their first two or even their thumb, to grab the ground and push off. The uncanny thing was it was in an upright position, and it went down to it was down to the ground where it's almost on all fours. I don't know how to describe it. It went from that position to another position so fast that it's just the lightning speed of this thing was insane. I think I told you earlier when I was talking to you, it was kind of like an animation film that would be kind of crummy, where you normally animate it through all the motions. You might have like five frames for it to move down into that position.
Yeah,
there was none of that. This thing was just from one position to the next in a split heartbeat. I mean, I couldn't even blink my eyes that fast. And I heard it thump as it grabbed into the ground with his hand. And it was like, ba-dunk and boom. I heard two of those, and my girlfriend heard those moving away sound. And she didn't see it, though. And right as soon as that happened, I get up and I go, hey, there's, that thing was right there. And Wes, this thing was like 10 to 12 feet behind me. It was just incredible. It took off about, I'd say, 20 yards or 15 yards only, just quickly into the bush that was there. And then we're realizing there's two of them because we can hear them. And they're both... Now there's kind of more of excited movement. It's not sneaky movement. It's excited movement where maybe the feet are moving more or whatever it is. But we're hearing shuffling or something in that bush. But it wasn't one. It was two. And my girlfriend confirmed me. She says, hey, there's another one in there. There's two of them. And I said, yeah, for sure.
That's kind of terrifying when you're not expecting it, to have it come up and bam, it's right there. But a lot of people, they don't hear it until it's right on top of them. They have a weird way of sneaking around campsites. Let me ask you, was it mainly kind of an outline? Is that, because I know the lighting conditions aren't great, was it kind of an outline? Is that what you're seeing?
Well, it was the eyes. I could see, it's weird. There was only 10, 12 feet from me, but it's almost like you have eagle vision, like when I locked eyes. I mean, I'm an artist. I could draw you detailed eyes. I mean, you can see all sorts of detail in the actual physical eye. It's strange. And when that happened, when I split second focused on those eyes, you could see the outline of the body. You know what I mean?